All right, now. All right. Greetings, all. This is just experimental live stream. I have never played this. I played this game for a little bit before, but I haven't played it for like that long. So. Welcome. You didn't see the title, we're playing The Evil Within. I started playing this a little bit, but honestly, I didn't get far enough into it to really get anywhere. So anyway, if my controller bugs out a little bit, then it's because, let's see. Like, if my controller may bug out a little bit, and yeah, it is bugging out right now. Look at it. It's bugging out. If it bugs out too much, we won't be able to go on. I won't be able to play this. Alright, so we'll start new game. Yeah. I'm sure. I always like to go a little bit brighter, just for the heck of it. We'll go with casual difficulty. I want to get this on PS3. I really do want to get this on PS3.
All units, 1199, expedite cover code 3, Deacon Mental Hospital.
I imagine...
184 copy, code 3, ETA 3 minutes. Sorry, detectives. I know you're just coming off a case, but I'm afraid we're gonna have to make a detour.
Sounds serious. Is it a riot?
A call went out just before I picked you up. Said it was multiple homicides. Half a dozen units already on scene.
131, please advise.
Hey, maybe it's the ghost of that doctor who went schizo and chopped up all those patients.
That's not what happened. Some patients disappeared.
Joseph, you think there's a connection?
It's a possibility. I believe the records were sealed.
Anyone on scene, respond.
Dispatch, this is Detective Castellanos in 184. What's the situation? Over.
184, be advised. Some problem with the son of Deacon Memorial.
Is there any...
God damn it! Jesus!
Essentially heard that this game is plays like feels like Resident Evil 4, but plays like but controls like Resident Evil 6.
Any thoughts?
Nothing yet. I'm sure we'll know everything once we get there.
You got out of practice. I'd like to know how the stream is running so far.
Contact dispatch and let them know what's happening. Joseph, Kidman, you're with me. We're gonna have a look around.
Right.
Man, look at this running animation. Kind of a rather stiff running animation, don't you think? Anyway, I was saying about the PS3 version that this, I imagine the PS3 version is, has much, the loading times in the PS3 version are horrible. How come they walk like that and I walk like this? I run like,
smells like blood.
All right, stay sharp.
Like I said, this is just honestly a test, so we're not gonna be doing this for that long.
We're gonna check it out. Don't let anyone else through this door.
I can be an extra set of eyes.
We don't know what's happening here. You're a backup.
Essentially, the whole idea of this game is kind of ludicrous, from what I understand. You're essentially stuck in come on.
Did you hear something? Someone alive in here.
Bunch of dead people.
Are you injured? What happened here?
Can't be real. Impossible. Ruvik is...
I've got him. The security cameras might tell us something.
I thought I was able to draw my gun earlier when I first played this. Hold on. Let me make sure. Yeah, graphic content is disabled. That doesn't sound nice. At all. Alright, so... So essentially, from what I've heard, this game is essentially a PlayStation 3 game, just essentially enhanced for PS4. Game looks amazing anyway. Checkpoint. Shit. This is about where I stopped last time. Well, that's disgusting. I heard this game started with a bang. I imagine loading times would be pretty bad on the PS3 version, but as the loading times are pretty bad on PS4. Anyway. I also heard that this game does not hold your hand whatsoever.
Where's the exit?
Useful in here, huh? Old note from sewer. Beside the locked gate at the far end of the sewer, there is a ladder which would take you to the old ward. If you could make it through there, you would find an elevator leading outside. Wait, hold on. Beside the locked gate at the far end of the sewer, there is a ladder which would take you to the old ward. If you could make it through there, you would find an elevator leading outside. You would be the one who escaped. You would be the one who survived. Give me a gun. Shit. Nothing there. It's a locked gate. Give me a damn gun. Shit. What I understand, there's some like system operation test begin. Success. Confirmation of brainwave synchronization. Losses minimal. Continuing experiment. Agent collects the data. Anomaly occurs not with the subject. The stenographer claimed they weren't feeling well and then fell into a coma for reasons unknown. Doctor orders the STEM system terminated. Staff begins complaining of nausea and falling unconscious one after another. Those who can still move plan their escape from the hospital, but for unknown reasons are unable to, though the STEM system should have been deactivated. Subjects maintain brainwave synchronization with the host. Heh, that man appeared. Okay. Oh, this is a door. Seeing a checkpoint in a horror game. Is like, I'm not really good tonight, dude. See what's doing? My finger is not on the thumb stick. It's not on the stick at all. This There's nothing in here. This is odd. What am I supposed to do there? Come on. He's got another checkpoint.
See me.
Come
Just seeing that checkpoint sign makes me feel kind of safe.
Within darkness twisting me around, there is nothing I can do.
Well, I'm not gonna stay up all night, but I don't see that guy again.
Sorry, but you never came out. I waited, but... Please, settle down, Leslie.
Settle down, Leslie. Settle down, Leslie. Settle down, Leslie.
Shit! There's no going back.
Thank you.
Are we cut off from everyone?
Everyone must be dead.
Everyone all right back there?
Just a few bumps. We're fine.
Fine. Fine. Fine.
We will be once we're far away.
Fine.
A little further and we'll be fine.
Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine.
Fall! Fall!
Welcome to the evil within. Glad that's over. Shit. Well, it's getting late. Damn, that was pretty scary. I'm not gonna lie, that was pretty scary. Like, that was a legitimately scary game. All right. There are a lot of games where I'm just not legitimately scared, you know? There are some games where there's obviously tension, there's frustrating moments. You're obviously afraid of some moments to happen again because, like, for instance, I was playing Resistance 3 recently. And Resistance 3, probably the most pain in the ass probably the moments you're scared of most is when you're when you're essentially caught in the middle of a bunch of these monsters, called Reapers, and their little bug friends, and man, those things are a pain in the ass. Don't get me wrong, they're not the most difficult part, they don't make for the most difficult parts of the game by any means. What makes for the most difficult parts of the game is enemies with rocket launchers. But anyway, yeah, I mean, we didn't get into any combat, which I kind of regret for this gameplay. I was actually showing this game off to a friend who might be interested in getting the game. But I'll tell you, that was an interesting intro. I know what the game is about. I'm not going to spoil it, but it's, I know what's going on there, so it's not like I'm freaked out at all, but I don't want to spoil it for anybody. But I will say, it's a legitimately scary game. Also a show for my friend who's not, there is, to show from my friend, there's sadly the alternate options are fairly limited. Alternate language options are fairly limited. The graphic content, I have that disabled mainly because this game, as you can see with the chainsaw and everything else, I mean, it only goes, like, you know, downhill from there as far as how much Well, as far as how much, as how gory the game gets. So, yeah, it goes, keeps going. Oh yeah, I want all those. Yeah. That's the evil within. Anyway, obviously I don't have any viewers right now, but if anybody who comes onto my channel later and decides, hey, I'd like to see more of this gameplay, let me know and I will stream some more of this for you. I don't think I'll be doing a full Let's Play on it anytime soon, but I may do a review of it. Yeah. It's the first chapter of The Evil Within. Anyway, this is Justinian the Great, signing off. Yeah.